Hi, I'm Julie Roberts. Welcome to kindergarten at Robey Elementary. And today we have our special guest, Mr. Rick Crosslin. And our lesson today is about how plants are alike and how they are different.
Hey, thanks for that great introduction. What a great class. I mean, I see science everywhere. Hungry caterpillars, I guess you guys like them, right?
Yeah.
Well, you know what? There's one thing that caterpillars really love, because caterpillars have to eat. And what do they eat? They eat
apples,
oranges, or any type of green
leaves
or plants. Plants. They love plants. They lay their egg on a leaf, right? Well, we're going to study plants today. In fact, we're going to talk about four different types of plants, and we're going to be talking about how are plants alike and different. Can you guys help me read this? Let's do it together. Plants can be different shapes, sizes, and colors. So plants can be different shapes, sizes, and colors. So who can look at these plants? Are they different sizes?
Yes.
Which one is a big one?
The tree,
right?
Yeah.
And which one is a small one, do you think?
Flower.
Yes.
That one.
This one, the flower or the cactus? The cactus. And this one's called a morning glory. It's like grows everywhere. Hey, what about their colors? Are they different colors? Or are they all the same color? What do you think? What about the color? What color does most plants have? Most plants have some color of what?
Green.
Green. Does this have green? Yes or no?
Yes.
Does this have green?
Yes.
What about this one?
Yes.
And that one?
Yes.
So they can be green, but they also can have other things, right? Well, let's see. I'm going to read this, then you read it. Plants can feel rough or smooth. Go ahead.
Plants can be rough or smooth.
What part of these plants do you think feels smooth?
The flower.
The flower probably feels smooth. What's something else that feels smooth? Yes?
The leaves.
The leaves. But what do you think feels rough? Yeah.
The cactus.
I'm not even going to touch it, even though it's a photograph of the cactus. Those spines, right, feel rough. And what about the tree? What do you call this part right here?
A tree trunk.
What is it called?
Tree trunk.
A tree trunk. It's kind of like a stem, right? You think it's nice and smooth?
No.
What do you think it is? Rough?
Yeah.
Have you ever felt one?
Yeah.
Oh, then you know.
They're rough.
Yeah, and if you feel them, sometimes they're bumpy and rough.
But
let's try this one. So these plants might be alike or different, and I brought some plants for us to take a look at. Would you like to see some plants?
Yes.
Okay, let's take a closer look. Hey, Nathan, I brought a plant. Now, this one could be kind of strange. Are you brave? Push your sleeve up. All right, wait till you see this plant. Shut your eyes. Put your hand in here and feel what this plant is. Put your hand inside of it. Don't look. Shut your eyes. Sit down, young man. Sit down for a second.
His face looks kind of creepy.
What in the world did you find? Pull it out. Pull it up. What are you? Hold that up. What do you have?
That's a fish tank.
Okay. You call that seaweed? Let me keep holding that for a second. I call that. So, Nathan, this here is a wet plant, an aquatic plant, and it's actually three different types of plants. Put it back in there for a second. Here's one part right here. Look, pull that up. Pull that apart. Grab it and pull it. That's called hair algae. It looks like green hair.
Is that, one of your fish tanks?
It is one of my fish tanks. Some plants grow where, Nathan? In what?
Fish tank.
In water. See if you can pull out a leaf in there. You see anything that's like a leaf? Here, pull that one out and separate it. Okay, so that plant, and pull some of the hair algae off. Oh, you dropped it. Hold it back up. What can you tell me about that plant? Hold it for everybody to show them. Show everybody. What can you tell me about that plant, Nathan?
That it has leaves.
It has leaves. What color is it?
Green.
Green? Let me get one just like it. So here's a leaf. Now, wait a minute. Listen, put it up by your ear. Mine's talking to me. You know what mine's saying? What did it say? What do plants need? It's saying it needs something. What does it need?
Sun.
You heard? I heard that too. Let's hold it up to the light. Hold them both up. You know what it just said? Everybody say this with me. It says, "Ah, thanks. I needed that." Everybody say it.
Ah, thanks. I needed that.
I'll bring it back down. All plants need sunlight. And we can do it one more time. Hold it up to the sun. Ah, thanks. I needed that. Say it.
Thanks. I needed that.
So plants need that. What else? Hold that. What else do plants need? What is that?
Water.
Wait a minute. Listen to it again. What's it saying? What does it need?
Water.
All plants need
water.
Water. And what do they say?
Oh, I need
thanks.
That.
I needed that. That's nice. Oh, wait a minute. Here's, look at this little guy right here. He's got leaves and roots. What is he saying? Listen. He's saying, what does he need?
I need air.
How did you know that? All plants need air. Ready, everybody? And what did the plants say? Thanks. I need it. Hey, give me 5 on that one.
Oh, don't get me wet.
Good job. Get me all wet on that one. Go on, Nathan. Hand me that hand lens right there. There's a little hand lens. So this is a... Thank you. Take a look at that. You use one, I'll use one. You look on that side, and let's see here. I'll do it from this back here, and let's see. I want you to take a close look at these later, okay? But look here. Here's the plant. Scoot over to the side so everybody can see. Guys, you're doing a great job on your pockets. I love it. So here is a water lily. How are these two plants alike, Nathan?
Because they're green.
Do you guys agree?
Mm-hmm.
They're both green, and they both live where?
In water.
In water. And they all need?
Sun.
Sun. And they all need?
Air.
And they all need?
Water.
Good job. Would you put that somewhere in your room that everybody can take a look at it? And then we'll take a closer look at our next plant. This is Hadley, and Hadley, you selected some interesting, very interesting plants. Now, how are these like the other plants we just looked at? What color are they?
Green.
Green. And what are these called, do you think?
Cactus.
You guys know that these are cactus, right?
Yeah.
And there's two different ones, but both of these cactus, oh, they're so soft and lovely. Should we touch them?
No.
Yeah. What do you think, Hadley? Should I touch this one?
Yes.
Why? Why not?
No.
I'm asking Hadley.
Yes.
Hadley, why should I not touch this cactus?
Cactus. Pokey.
It is pokey. Mm-hmm. Cactuses have spines, but I'm going to tell you a secret. Do you know what spines really are? You know what they really are? They are a type of leaf. The spine is a type of leaf. Hadley, where does a cactus live? Do you have any idea where you might find a cactus in the wild?
In the sand.
It lives in sand. Where else is it?
Hot.
Very what, kids?
Hot places.
Hot places? And what do you call a hot place with sand and lots of sun and very little rain? What is that called?
Desert.
The what?
Desert.
The desert. Did you know that?
That's what I was about to say.
I know. I love the desert. Now, it has these spines, so other animals, ouch, won't eat it to get its what? What do you think's inside of it?
Lava.
Water. Water. And so if you live in the desert, Hadley, and you're really thirsty, and you look around, you go, well, gonna have to eat a cactus. The cactus is gonna go, oh, not again. The cactus can't run away, can it?
No.
It can't say, stay away. So the cactus protects itself with what?
The pokey stuff.
Yeah. And we call that what, kids?
Leaves.
They're leaves, but they're special
spines.
In fact, Hadley, use one of these hand lens and take a close look at yours. I'll take a close look. Oh, my goodness. These are covered in spines. How about yours?
Yeah.
Oh, they're. But you know what? Let me show you this one right here. Let me hold your lens for a second. This part is not. Would you feel that part of the camera? No, on mine. Feel this right here. How does that feel?
It's smooth.
It's smooth. And
the other parts are like bumpy and they hurt.
Yeah. And so this one is actually smooth and hard. I've been in the desert, and when it rains, it doesn't rain very much, but plants need what?
Water.
Water. When it does rain, you know what happens? The cactus does this. Soaks up all the water. See how skinny that is right there? Mm-hmm. It swells up. Look here, Hadley. Look, see this cactus right here? Mm-hmm. This is called a fish hook barrel cactus. And if you look at it, what shape is it?
Is that this thing?
An oval.
An oval. And look at these. Those are like hot dogs, right? And this cactus has flowers. Mm-hmm. I have been in the desert when one of these cactuses, after it rains, swells up like a big bag. And then it holds that water and keeps it. So how is this like the other one? It is, what color is it?
Green.
Green. And, oh, wait a minute, it's talking to me. Is yours talking to you? It's saying,
yeah.
What is it saying it needs?
Sun.
And what did it just say?
Oh.
Ah, thanks. I needed that. Wait a minute, it's saying something else. What did it say?
Water.
It needs water.
Ah. Thanks, I needed water.
What did it
say? Thanks, I needed that.
Wait a minute. One more thing it said. What did it say?
I need air.
Everybody?
Thanks, I needed that.
What does it say?
Thanks, I needed that.
You guys are amazing. Hadley, thank you. Be careful as you walk because you don't want any of these special leaves that we call spines to go home with you, right? To stick you. So this cactus and this plant are alike and different. Let's take a closer look at one more. Hey, look what you picked, Caleb. Now that's not a cactus, right? And that's not a water plant. What did you select?
Tree.
A tree. And this is a special kind of tree. I thought about bringing in a giant maple tree, but I didn't have a truck, so I brought a small tree. So tell me about this tree. What do you know about this tree, man? What does it have on it that you recognize?
Spine.
It does. Is that? I don't see. Where's your spine? Do you feel spines on it?
Yeah.
What are these things called?
Leaves.
It has leaves. What do you call this part of a tree?
The trunk.
Is he right?
Yes.
The trunk is usually what color?
Brown.
And the trunk makes the tree stand up, doesn't it? And also, what goes all the way up this trunk to all these leaves? What do you think goes up in there? Soaks up from the ground, goes all the way up.
Water?
Yeah, water. Water goes up and down. Now, this one is bigger. It doesn't have any spines, but sometimes trees have thorns. Have you ever seen a tree with thorns?
Oh, yeah.
No.
Have you? Is anybody?
Yeah.
And now, this tree is going to get bigger. It has leaves. Wait a minute. Let's see. How is it different from this tree here, Caleb? This tree, how is it different from this one?
It doesn't have any orange leaves.
Doesn't have any orange leaves. What else? Look at the size of that one.
It's not as big as that size.
No, this one will stay small. It's a special type of tree. And we talked how it's like. Wait a minute. Do you hear it say something? Listen carefully. Turn your other ear. Let's do this here. What's it saying?
Sun.
What does it say it needs?
Sun.
I needed that.
Let me see what it is. If it's listening to anything else. What else does it need?
Water.
Well, let's water it. What did it say?
Thanks, I needed that.
Is that all?
No!
What else? Listen. Thanks.
I needed that.
So here's a tree. Now let's take the microscope or hand lens here. I don't know, maybe we can see. Oh, do you see a squirrel living in that tree?
No.
You know? You see a bird?
No.
What else might we see? If we were in the jungle, what do you see?
A raccoon.
You saw a raccoon? Check it out. A squirrel, a raccoon, a bird might be living in the tree. Caleb? Good job. So we've talked about a cactus, a water plant, and a tree. I got one more to show you. Wow. You picked a very interesting one. Look at this thing. It has this long vine. That's different. It's not going up like, what was that last one?
A tree.
It's not spiky, is it? No. And it's not in the water. What can you tell me about this? What does it have on it? It has no spines. What else does it have on it? What do you think?
No water.
It's not underwater, is it? Oh, you know what this is? This is, everybody can say this. It's called a vine. Can you say vine?
Vine.
So a tree had a trunk. The water was in that was in the water. The cactus had a spine. You know what? You're going to be a fence. Here's your arm. You're a fence post. You're a fence post. And you know what this plant likes to do at a fence post? It likes to do this. It likes to grow around.
I have a honeysuckle that likes to do that.
You have a honeysuckle that likes to do that? Well, you're the perfect kid. Does it go right around there? And look at this one. He goes right here and tickles your nose. In fact, be still. Look at the camera right there. Look at your teacher. This will grow. Turn my head just a little bit. This will grow right up there. Now look at the camera. That thing likes to grow wherever it can. So a vine untangles. But if you put your other hand up, it will start to tangle again because it likes to go high. Why do you think a plant wants to go up in the sky? Wait a minute, it's going to ask you, listen to it. What's it saying? What's it saying? Oh, it wants to go up to the sun? Let's do it. And what does it say now? Anything else does it need? Listen to it. What is it saying? Go ahead and water it. Now what does it say?
Thanks, I needed that.
And this vine has one more thing to say to you. Let's see, here it comes. It's crawling towards you. Slowly, slowly. And what did it say this time?
I needed that.
Take a look at it with your hand lens and tell me if you can see one thing that's interesting to share. What do you see? Leaves. Hold it up like this. Let's look one more time at it. I see leaves. Oh, and the leaves are interesting. They have veins in them. So let's talk about, would you take that and back, take those back over there. And I'll tell you, boys and girls, all trees have, and all plants have things that are similar. They could be green, and a lot of them have flowers. Have you ever seen a flower? Trees have flowers. Small plants have flowers. This water has flowers. Cactus has flowers. Trees have flowers. Vines have flowers. Flowers are a big part of trees. And you know what? Well, this is interesting. Flowers turn into seeds. And I brought some special seeds. Let's take a look at these seeds, okay? So, if you're a flower, your job is to make seeds. But here's the problem. Like on that tree, when the seeds fall down, they start to grow. They can't get any sunlight because the big tree blocks it out. So we got to find some way for the seeds to spread apart. And here is one way. Maybe you've seen these. I hope this works. I'm going to make something. Maybe you can make them too. So here is maybe you've seen this before. So I don't know. Maybe you've seen these in your yard. I hope this works. Let's see. This goes like this. Wait a minute. This goes like this. Let's see. And this is going to be my seed. And let's see here. I'm going to borrow a marker right here. Here we go. And I'm going to make a seed. This is a big seed. And how do you spell seed? S-E-E-D. So here's my seed. Now, we want that seed to fall from the tree, but if it lands under the tree, it's going to be in the shadow, and it won't do very well. So, let's see what happens. Here we go. Ready? What did it do? Did you see it?
It spins.
It spins, and it spins out of the way. Let's try it one more time. Ready? Here we go. Oh, no. That one didn't spin too much. Let's see. Let's try it again.
I know what you're talking about.
Have you seen something like this?
Yes.
Those are airplanes.
Let it land right on the floor.
Those are helicopters.
They're like helicopters, right? Let's see.
Don't catch it.
Don't catch it. Let it land.
Land.
Oh, you know what? That's a big one. Let's see. That's a big one. Put it right there. What if there's a little seed, though? Do you think a little one will work?
Yeah.
I don't know. Let's find out. You want it that small? Hold that.
Yeah, that is certainly small.
Seeds can be big or small. Let's see. Plants make seeds. I don't know if this will work. Give me a thumbs up if you think it'll work. Thumbs down if you don't think it'll work. In science, we make predictions, and then we test them. So this way, if you're not sure, thumbs up, yes. Don't know, no, it won't work. What's your prediction?
Science.
All right, here we go. Here we go, let's see if this will work. Where's my marker? This is a small seed. Oh, this might work, I don't know. Let's find out, here we go, ready? 3, 2, 1, seed. Did it work? I think it did. In fact, you said you knew what those are, right? Didn't you say, what did you say?
Helicopter.
Come up here and help, over here and help me. What's your name? Come over here. Samuel. So you've seen these before? Turn around. Thank you. You've seen these before? Hold that one.
Yeah.
How does it work? How do you do it?
I planted a seed of those.
Whoa! That's a plant, how it spreads its seed. Let them land. Don't catch them if you can help it. Show me again. Whoa. Try another one.
It's going to be a seed.
It's right on there.
Let's try. Let me try one, Sam. Ready?
So
1, 2, 3.
Go!
As a matter of fact, let me stand up. You guys sit
right there.
Can I keep it?
Can I
catch
it? Let's try this. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Okay. Wait a minute, hold on. You guys stay seated. And let's give Samuel a round of applause for helping you with that and observing. Thanks. Have a seat. Hey, Samuel, put your wings out like a seed and rotate on back to your spot. Let's see you rotate.
Someone broke it.
Here he goes, here he goes, here he goes, here he goes, here he goes. Nice job. Hey, so I thought that gave me an idea. I found some of these in my yard. Have you ever seen anything like this before?
Yes.
And these are actual seeds from a plant. Let's see what they'll do. Okay, so I got three helpers here. You guys have already seen these in your yard, right?
Yeah, I cut them down.
I cut them down too. This used to be a flower called a dandelion flower, and when the flower is done, it makes the seeds, right? But the seeds like to travel. So you hold this one. You hold this one. There you go. And you hold this one and come in close to me. Come in close to me. And let's, on the count of three, you be the wind and blow these. Put them up here by your face and let's blow them out to our audience. You guys, are you ready for this?
Yes!
1, 2, 3, blow. There they go. Seeds everywhere. What can I say? The seeds are everywhere. Let's take a close look at what's left. So after we blew the seeds left, all that's left of the flower is that empty parts of the petal. But the seeds are everywhere. Plants like to spread their seeds. So we've studied plants up close. I'm going to leave them in your room so you can study them overnight. But let's take a look. We talked about a water plant. And to make a water plant, I'm going to make a container like this. So you can go ahead and draw this too. Here's my container. You draw it on yours. And you know what? I'm going to put some blue. You don't have to have blue, but I'm going to put some blue for water. And you know what? That plant looked like this. One of them, you might want to use your green crayon. It looked like hair algae. It's like pieces of hair. You see that one that my friend had? Do that. And the other one had leaves on it. It kind of looked like this. Remember that? And I'm going to say, write the word water. It was wet. Should I write wet or water? What do you want to write? Wet. Okay. W-E-T. Let me take a look at yours.
Nice drawing. Nice drawing, guys. So you have your wet plant. Good job.
So we also talked about a tree. Now, a tree has a, what's that part called?
Trunk.
Make your fist go like this. There's the trunk. And then all of a sudden, it starts to grow branches, right? And then leaves come. So I'm going to make my tree right here. I'm going to start with a trunk. And then branches. Take your branches, go wherever you want. And my friend, was it Caleb that helped me with the tree?
Yeah.
I'm gonna put a bird up in my tree. And did he say a raccoon?
Yeah.
I'm gonna have a raccoon crawling up the side of my tree.
And that one would have a funny way.
Because a tree has a trunk, and it also has lots of
what? Look at this.
Leaves.
Leaves. Go ahead. All right, so then we looked at a, it was kind of prickly. It was kind of spiny. It was a what?
Cactus.
The cactus. And ours kind of looked like this. You can make them any way you want, but I kind of like a cactus that looks like this. It was kind of round, right? There was one in the book that was like this and had all these what on it?
Spines.
And here's another one looked like this. You ever seen a cactus that looks like this? Comes up like that, goes up like that. You ever seen a cactus like that?
Yes.
And it has spines. So go ahead and make your cactus, either one. It doesn't have to be exactly like this. All right, so that leaves our potted plant. Now I'm gonna do something special. I'm gonna put the pot way up here, right? You know why? Huh, you're gonna know why, because I want, what is this called? This is my
vine.
I want my vine to go everywhere, and then I'm going to put leaves all over it. So there's my vine, and I need to add some leaves. Go ahead. Make yours.
And you want to color a few more in, Lil? Mm-hmm. Can I put a leaf right here?
Mm-hmm.
Your leaves are better than mine. And what do you call that big thing right there?
A vine.
And those sticking out here are called a?
Spines? Spines.
And what's that part of the tree called?
Trunk.
You're an expert. Nice job.
Okay, so that's how they're different. This one is wet. This one has spines. S-P-I-N-E-S. This one is wet. This one has a trunk, right? And this one has a vine. But how are they alike? Let's put how they're alike right here. All plants need
sun.
They need sun. All plants need
air.
And all plants need
water.
And almost all plants are what color?
Green.
And almost all plants make what that fly through the air or land on the ground?
Seeds.
So here is how they are alike. Let's say these again. All plants need
sun,
air, water. Most of them are green, and most of them have seeds. Let's do one more thing with our seeds. Well, this has been a great class to learn about plants. And finally, we have some seeds. So I think we need to share the seeds with the world. Are you guys ready to throw our seeds up and see where they land?
Yeah!
Okay. I can't wait, but my seed's saying something to me. It's saying, listen to your seed. It's saying, throw me in the air on the count of three. Ready?
One,
two,
three.
Well, hey, thanks for letting me come in your room. We've had a really great time.